Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today, I have a video that was requested. I had posted a like question box on my Instagram and asked what videos I should upload, and I literally wrote them all down. And I decided I'm just literally gonna knock them out and film one by one. So for today, I'm gonna be showing you guys basically my shoe collection. And I've done a couple of videos, I think either one or two. I can't remember exactly how many. Okay, so this is gonna be a long video. This is gonna be a long intro. So basically, if you have been following me for a very long time, and I mean like when I was living in New York, like back then, you know that the amount of shoes that I owned was unhealthy. It was stupid. It was unnecessary. And I didn't care. I love shoes, and I know that some people think that spending money on shoes is stupid, and that is perfectly fine. You are entitled to your opinion, because there are a lot of things that I think spending money on are stupid, like a car. I think cars are stupid, and I think buying expensive cars are stupid. I will roll with the same car until my car wheels fall off. That's just my opinion, but I will spend money on shoes very, like, a lot easier. In the last couple of years, I have really, really downsized my shoe collection. I sold probably 80 pairs of shoes. I had almost 100 pairs of shoes before. And with all these shoes, like, one, where was I wearing all these shoes? I don't know. Great question, because I don't know why I needed that many pairs of shoes. But I would also buy, like, $20 pair of shoes, $30 pair of shoes. Like, I bought cheap shoes, and obviously, like, if that's in your budget, there's nothing at all that's wrong with that. But I also noticed that those shoes were very easily falling apart. I remember a pair of boots that I wore out to a brunch. The heel broke, like literally the heel snapped while I was at brunch. And I remember after that day, I was like, no, I am done with any shoes that I know are not made very, very well. And there are plenty of shoes that are made well that aren't inexpensive. But this is just my opinion. I feel like what you put on your feet needs to be good quality, because you are walking in them, the amount of wear that they get on them, like, this is what your feet are in. I am the type of person that I will wear a $4 shirt, a $10 pair of jeans, and I'll wear $500 pair of shoes. And that's just me, that's just my opinion. I don't spend money on clothes really at all anymore, since I do own my own online boutique. Like, I have too many clothes at this point. I don't spend money on expensive bags. It's just not my thing. I don't care for purses. I think they're beautiful, and I really would like to have one, but I would rather spend the money on shoes than I would on like a bag or a wallet or anything like that. Shoes are just my thing. Shoes have always been my thing. I am known for shoes. I love helping people find shoes. I love all types of shoes. I love heels, especially. I love heels, and I am the one that's always overdressed. Anywhere that I can wear a pair of heels to, I will, because I love the way that they make me feel. I love how they change my outfit. I love the confidence that it gives me. I don't know what it is, but throwing on a pair of heels, even if it's with jeans and like a white t-shirt, it's like you turn into a completely different person. So this extremely long intro to say, if you think it's ridiculous to spend this much money on shoes, like I said, that's your opinion. You're allowed to think that, but this is what I like to spend my money on, and I work extremely hard. I just hit my 30th birthday yesterday, so some of these shoes are for my birthday. Almost every pair of shoes that I have, I've purchased at like a milestone. Pretty much every single pair, actually. Some of them are higher, some of them are lower in price range. They're just kind of scattered all over the place, but this is my shoe collection, so I hope you guys enjoy it. So I'm not going in any like specific order at all. I'm literally just gonna pick up the first pair that I see. So the first pair that I have are these right here, and these are my Louboutin Pegalls. And these are 100mm, which means they're about 4 inches in height. If you guys remember, if you've been here for a while, I used to own the Silkates. And Silkates are 120mm, which means they're about 5 inches. And in my opinion, those just weren't realistic to wear all the time. And if I was going to invest in a pair of pumps that I wanted to wear all the time, I was gonna do something that was a little bit shorter. I loved my Silkates. They made me feel so like sexy. The way that they make your foot look is just like unlike any other shoe. Like, that shoe is made to make you look like a boss ass bitch. That's honestly what it's like. But I just decided to sell those, which one of my followers, actually Letty, she ended up buying them for me, and I hope you're loving them. I hope you're wearing them nonstop. I got like the soles repaired on them. I did like everything to them because I really love them, and those were like my goal shoe. Like, I was like, I need a pair of nude patent Louboutins, and I ended up buying them. Obviously ended up selling them, and then when I sold them, I basically used that money, which I do a lot. I'll sell a pair of shoes and I'll use that to pay for something else. So I ended up buying the Pagals. And the one thing that I kind of regret in buying these was that I actually ended up buying these on Poshmark. And I am like a big fan of buying like secondhand designer. Some stuff I have, I bought brand new, and some stuff I bought secondhand. If you can buy a designer item that's secondhand and it looks great in quality, do it. Like, save your money and buy something that is either lightly worn, gently worn, barely used, and save yourself $200 or $300. And that's how it was with the Soulcate. How much did I sell the Soulcates for? I think I sold the Soulcates for $400, and those shoes retail at almost $800, I think. Almost at $800. So I sold them obviously for way cheaper in price, and they were like practically brand new. So with these, I can't remember how much I bought them for. I think I spent like $400 on them as well. But the only thing that I'm really upset that I wish I would have considered it more is that I don't know exactly what the person that owned them before me did, but there's like a black stain on the heel. And I take my shoes to a cobbler to get like fixed up with like the heels getting redone and all that, and getting the red bottom grip put in, but that's something that can't be repaired. And I kind of regret spending that much money on a shoe that had that big of a defect, and I saw it beforehand and I just made a stupid decision on buying them. I'm hoping at some point I can find someone that can fix that, but these actually were in the bag because I wore the heel all the way down, so the metal is coming through, so I have to take them to go get repaired. But these are my first pair. I love them. I think that they are worth every penny. Now, if you're going to the 120s, I think that that's where they're like 120 mms, they're just too high for me to be able to wear every day. If you only want them for like a very special occasion shoe, then that's completely different. I think that 120 mms are real cute to like go in, sit down for dinner, wear for your birthday, things like that. But I just decided to go for a shorter heel and I do not regret it. I love them. These are patent as well. The way that they make your foot look is just beautiful. And yeah, that is my first pair of shoes. Now I'm going to show you guys a shoe that is way different on the spectrum of price, and these are a pair of Steve Madden. Look at how beautiful this color is. These are a pair of Steve Madden sandals, and I haven't even been able to wear these yet because we haven't, like, we're on lockdown basically. But I bought these for myself, I think, around Christmas time, and I was like, oh my god, once the spring comes, like, these are going to look so pretty with, like, all white or, like, a denim outfit, white toes, a nice tan. And here we are, locked down, and I can't wear anything anywhere. But I love these. They're beautiful. I love the pointed toe right here. Like, they're just so pretty, and they're really, really soft material. I normally am not a Steve Madden fan. I don't know. I just feel like his shoes are overpriced for what they are, if I'm going to be completely honest. I'm not a fan. I'm not someone that will spend my money on Steve Madden, because if I'm going to spend $150 on a pair of shoes, I'm going to spend maybe 200 more and get a pair that I know will not mess up on me. However, I love these. I think the color is just to die for. They had a whole bunch of different colors and I almost wanted like three other colors, but I stopped myself because I was like, girl, you don't need any more. And I don't have any shoes that are this color. Like, these are like a vibrant coral and the camera is not even picking them up, as vibrant as they are. They're beautiful and I can't wait to wear these. If they still have them on Steve Madden's website, or if I can find them anywhere, I'll leave them linked down below, but they're beautiful. Next, I have my baby pink Pagals, and they are so beautiful. These are from Louboutin as well. They just got the grips put on. I just paid for them to get done, and I just got the heel caps replaced. These are very worn. I wear these and I love them so much. Tyler actually bought these for me on Valentine's Day like 3 years ago. He literally asked me, he was like, what do you want for Valentine's Day? And I was like, I don't know. And he was like, well, how about you get a pair of shoes? And I was like, okay. So I was like, how cute would it be for Valentine's Day to get a pair of pink heels? So I ended up picking these, and the only con that I have has nothing to do with the shoe, really. I let the girl that worked there convince me that I needed to size up, and I knew myself. I know, one, I already owned them before, so I knew, like, I don't know if she's right, but I was like, you know what? Let me take her professional opinion on them. I bought them at Neiman Marcus, and they ended up being so big on me after I started wearing them for a few minutes that I had to put, like, three rubber kind of like spacers in the back, because if not, they literally flop off my feet when I walk. And thankfully, after I put the rubber thingies in there, it took up some space and it worked really well. But aside from that, I love these. The color is the cutest baby pink. Like, I love these. I love these so much, and every time I look at them, I think of just like my girliest self, and they're absolutely beautiful. I love them. They're so cute. Next, I have my pair of black Yves Saint Laurent. Well, Saint Laurent because they dropped Eve. But these are my black Saint Laurent sandals, and this is what they look like right here. These were actually my Christmas gift from Tyler. He knows that all I like are shoes. Like, don't spend your money on anything else. Just buy me shoes. Because that's what I like. And I was in need, like, badly for a pair of black single strap sandals. I did not own any. Like, I don't have any. Gone. None. Zero. So I knew I wanted a pair of patent leather, and I knew I wanted a pair of YSL. And I love these. There's like glitter stuck on them because I wore them for a party. They're patent leather. They have a really, really skinny strap. A lot of people think these are uncomfortable. I honestly don't think they're that bad. They're like a little bit higher than 4 inches. So this is what the heel height looks like. But I love them. I love them so much. And these I actually found on The RealReal, which I shop on there all the time. So if you are looking to buy secondhand designer, 100% recommend The RealReal, because you can find like pretty much almost new items. And these were from The RealReal, and the condition was just perfect. Like, they were in perfect condition, had barely any signs of wear, nothing like that. And I love these. I think they're so like sexy and simple. I wore these for a date night. Tyler and I went on, and he was like, I think these are my favorite pair of your shoes, because he loved just like the really skinny strap and the little like ankle strap. They're beautiful. I love them. If you're a heel wearer, I would recommend them. If you don't normally wear heels, you'll probably think these are uncomfortable, but I love them. So the next shoe that I have, oh, these are falling. Oh my God, they're falling apart. Ooh, these are really bad. These were the first pair of designer shoes that I ever bought. These are my lace Manolo Blahniks. And I remember when I bought these shoes, I had just gotten my first huge commission check from my old job. I used to work at a luxury watch store, and our commission checks were wild. Like, I mean, we sold $10,000 watches. So it was like, my commission was always crazy. And I remember when I got my first big commission check, I was like, I'm getting myself a pair of Manolos. Because obviously anyone that watches Sex and the City, that's like the shoe. It took me so long to decide. And then I finally went with these because I loved that they were black, but that they weren't just plain black. Like, they had a little bit of detail to them. And these are, when I say worn, like, I have beat these shoes up. I really hope I can get this fixed, because this is like detached from the lace. One thing I will say though about these is that they're very delicate because they're lace. I don't know if you can even see here, like the trim is starting to pop off right here. This like lace meshy material is starting to kind of come undone. And because they're lace, this is really thin. I think I'm gonna get the soles done on these and get like black rubber caps on them, or like black rubber put on them, because they're really worn down. But I like, look at the heels. The heels got destroyed as well. I will never get rid of these. These can fall apart and I won't get rid of them. I will keep them forever because I remember how bad I wanted them, and I worked so hard that month to get my like my fat commission check, and I was like, I'm getting myself my pair of shoes. And I was so proud of myself when I came home with my Neiman Marcus bag. I love them so much. And these are actually discontinued. They're an older model. I bought these like 5 years ago, maybe 6 years ago, so they are pretty old. But if you search like Manolo lace heels, you might be able to find them. Next is a pair of shoes that Tyler bought me for Christmas 1 year. I think it was like 2 years ago. These are a little bit less in the price range, but they still are like a designer shoe. These are from the brand Schutz, and Schutz is a Brazilian designer, and their shoes are so comfortable. It's like scary how comfortable his shoes are, or her shoes. I don't even know if, I think it's a guy. I'm pretty sure it's a guy. But this is what the shoe looks like right here, and they are the most girly shoes that I own. This kind of like wraps around your foot, like wraps around your ankle, and then the tassels hang in the front. But you can see they're like the prettiest pink, like blush pink satin material. I love that this is frayed right here. They have a chunky heel, so they're so comfortable. But oh my God, they're so cute and so girly. Like, so girly. They're precious. I love them. I'm not sure if these are still available anywhere, but if I can find them, I'll leave them linked down below. Oh man, my royal blue babies. Here are my Stuart Weitzman pumps, and oh, I love these so much. The color, this is my, like, blue is my favorite color. I love blue so much, and I told myself I need to get a pair of royal blue pumps. Like, what is it? And these are actually extremely comfortable. I've worn these so many times. Very durable, because I have, I mean, they look pretty destroyed, but they're so comfortable. Super nice. I think I got these at Barney's. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I got these at Barney's, but I really like them. Obviously, they're super simple. It's literally just a royal blue pump, but I love them so much, and Yeah. Next, I have another Schutz shoe, and oh my god, these are beat up. I wear my shoes. Like, I don't just buy stuff to let it sit there. I wear my stuff. These are another pair of Schutz shoes, and these are their shoes called Katie Lee. It's probably my favorite style that Schutz makes, and these are a snakeskin sandal. It's like their simple strappy sandal, and they are so comfortable. Like, incredibly comfortable. I actually wore my nude ones to like the bone. Like, they died and got destroyed at a wedding. I like stepped on a in between wooden planks, and when I pulled my foot up, the entire heel, like screw and all, detached from here. Oh, it was rough, and I had to throw them away, and I was so sad because I loved my nude pair. I still wear these all the time. Like, I only have one printed heel, and it's these. And these are so good with like black if you want a pop of something. If you're wearing just like a really plain outfit and you want a little bit of something, this print I love because it's not a white like snake print. It's like a neutral snake print. So I really like that. Where did I buy these? I think I bought them on Schutz.com, like on Schutz website. I'm pretty sure they still have these available, so I'll leave them linked down below. But if they don't, I'll leave the style down below just because they're so good. Like, this is a pair of shoes that it's like, I would buy these in every single color if I needed a single strappy heel in every single color. I love them. Next, I have this pair of green, like emerald green snake print sandals. And I actually made my sister buy these for me. I didn't make her buy them for me, but my sister thinks that I'm her personal shopper and is always like, oh, buy, like, take my card and go online and just buy me clothes. Like, I need clothes. So anytime I do that, I charge her a commission and I'll buy myself something. So I was buying her some stuff from Misguided, and I saw these. It was right around, like, right before Christmas. And I was like, these would be so cute, like, for Christmas time because they're that beautiful, like, emerald green. I've only worn them once, but I have worn them. And I love them. I think they're so pretty. These were, like, $30. They're really, really inexpensive. But since they have a chunky heel, I don't feel scared walking in them because they're not like a thin heel that can bend. So if they still have these available, I don't think they do because they're old, but these are so cute. I love them. And like the ankle, like, they're so cute. I think they're so cute. And they were really affordable. Next is probably one of my favorite pairs of shoes that I have ever purchased for myself. And I can't remember why I bought these for myself, but it was an occasion. Like, I always buy myself shoes for like a special occasion, whether it's a goal that I hit or an anniversary of something or my birthday or anything, it's a pair of shoes that I buy myself. And these I have talked about before. You guys have seen me wear these multiple times. I've posted about them in videos. And these are my Gucci Ursula sandals. And look at the beauty. These shoes make me feel amazing when I wear them. The color is stunning. They're the perfect spring shoe. I bought these on The Real Real, and I think I ended up paying like $400 for them. These normally are almost $1,000, but because they're old, and because they're discontinued, I ended up finding them really cheap. And literally the second that I found them, I was like, I need to buy them right now. I literally grabbed my card, popped into my information, and when I got them, I was like, I am so happy with this pair of shoes. Like, these are beautiful. And you can see, again, I bought these used and they look pretty much brand new. That wear is for me. Like, this is for me. So I love them. Oh, love them so much. These are about a 5-inch heel, so if you're not used to wearing heels, these might be a little bit high, but they are made so well. And the fact that this is a cage and it holds your foot really well, I love these shoes so much, and I'm so glad I bought them. So glad. Next, I have another pair of Louboutins, and these are Pagals as well. These are the 100mm, and these are pretty beat. I wear the crap out of these. Like, You can see they're worn. I like destroyed the leather right here doing I don't know what. The heels are like shredded. I actually bought these on Poshmark, and I got them so cheap. Well, cheap for this shoe. These shoes normally retail, I think, for like $7.45 or $7.95. And I ended up getting them for like $2.50 because the lady was just getting rid of a whole bunch of her shoes, and they were in practically like brand new condition. They looked so good. You can see the inside is not very worn, and anywhere that's in there is for me. Like, I roughed these up, and she had already done the soles, so it was perfect because this actually protects your shoe from wearing down, and it gives you some grip because this is rubber. Love these. In my opinion, this leather is so comfortable because it's a regular leather, it's not patent. So oh my god, I love these so much. And the amount of wear that I get out of these, I wear them. If you go on my Instagram, I probably have like 10 pictures on my feed wearing them because I love them so much. Now, on the other side of the spectrum, I have these pair of Tony Bianco heels. These are, I mean, compared to all my other shoes, I don't think they're super pricey, but this is what the shoes look like, and I am obsessed with them. actually shocked that I've only worn them once, but I love them. I feel like these jeans or these shoes have to be worn with a very specific outfit. I don't like how they look with jeans. I like them more with like dresses or skirts or like a cropped kind of pant. I don't like them with long jeans, but the straps are so pretty and Tony Bianco heels are so comfortable. I think I paid like $130 for these, but they're made so well, like made very well. They have these little rubber grips on the bottoms, but I love them. I'm almost positive they're still available, so if I can find them on the Tony Bianco website, I will leave them linked down below as well. My most recent purchase, I bought these for myself for, it was a mix of my 30th birthday and me pretty much quitting my job and working solely for myself. These are my Louboutin Jonah Tina sandals and I love these shoes. I needed, because like I mentioned to you guys before, my nude Katie Lee from Schutz heels, I destroyed them. I literally have them sitting in my trunk still because I'm so sad about it. I destroyed them. So I did not have a single nude strapped heel. And I was like, I know I'm gonna wear a pair of nude heels with everything. So I want them to be great quality, a good designer, a pair of shoes that I know is gonna last me a really long time. So I bought myself my Jonah Tinas. I went back and forth for days. Like, I don't know, I shouldn't do it, I should do it, I don't know. These were very expensive, probably my most expensive shoe purchase. They were like $850, which I know is very expensive. But I know with the amount of wear that I'm gonna get out of these, I will wear these so much. I've already worn them. I mean, I haven't had them for that long because I just got them. But I wore them in Puerto Rico out to dinner with my friends, and then I wore them yesterday for my birthday in my house. But I didn't care, I was gonna wear them anyway. And I love them. This is like a, I can't remember the name of this. It's not acrylic, but it's like the clear strap right there, and then this goes around your ankle. So I love it because when the shoe is on, it looks like the strap is floating on your ankle. And then this strap here is nice and thick, so it's very comfortable on your feet. Most comfortable pair of Louboutins I own, hands down, because they're open toe. They're amazing. I didn't even get the soles done before I wore them because I was so excited that I didn't care. Love these, but these sell out all the time, which is one of the reasons that I got them. Like, finally, when I bit the bullet, I was like, I need to get them because if I don't, they're going to sell out. Every time I tried looking for them, they were sold out. There were plenty of occasions where I was like, I want to buy these for myself. I would check and they were sold out everywhere. So I would say if you do end up finding them, bite the bullet and get them because you will love them. Like, I love these almost as much as I love my Gucci Ursulas. Like, I love them. Now my last shoe, which this is a whole different category, but I have to include these. So I wanted these sneakers for a very long time. These are Saint Laurent sneakers and I had wanted them, and I remember Tyler asked me what I wanted for Valentine's Day and I was like, oh, I want either Saint Laurent sneakers or Golden Goose sneakers. I just wanted a really classic white pair of sneakers because I wear white sneakers a lot. Like, all the time. I'm trying not to touch the bottom because I've already worn them and, you know, germs and all that stuff. But he ended up getting me the Saint Laurent sneakers and my friend was able to get them for me and he hooked me up. So shout out to you, Swing. But these are beautiful. I love everything about them. The Saint Laurent is very simple on the side in gold and they're just literally standard white. But I love that this part, like the gum bottom part, is like off-white. It's so pretty. I love them. I've already worn them, but I haven't really left my house much, but I did wear them and I love them so much. What is this style? Blank Optique. So guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know, like I said a whole bunch of times, spending a lot of money on shoes is not a necessity, but for me, if there's one thing I'm going to spend my money on, it is my footwear. And it's something that I've always loved. I love collecting shoes. I love how beautiful they are. I love the way that they make me feel. A lot of people spend their money on makeup. A lot of people spend their money on bags. A lot of people spend their money on perfume. And I choose to spend my money on shoes. And if you work hard, you deserve whatever it is you want. It doesn't matter what it is. If you work hard, you deserve it. So I hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you guys in the next one.